Yep. Give me a level higher. Yeah, I can hear myself, but not too high. Maybe through the headphones, it's not that high. Oh yeah. No.
I like it really high. Yeah, I like it like that. Yeah. Maybe a little less. Now I can hear myself more, of course. Maybe throw the microphone up a little more.
When I have to throw music down, I don't have much more room to play on the microphone.
All right. Yeah, here we go. So, here we are.
Test 1, 2, check, 1, 2.
time.
And checking the mic for the weekly kill.
We're gonna hear ourselves.
We are gonna hear ourselves, Gilbank.
Check, check, check. All right.
Just doing a little Gilbank check. Gilbank. Yeah, just doing a little, hey, hey, I'm over here. I'm playing the trumpet over here.
Yeah, I'm just over here, man. Yeah, just playing the trumpet. Oh, doing a little drums now. It's amazing. You should see what I could do with one hand.
You asked for a drum.
Give it to me, soul power. Hey! Need it, soul power.
Hello. There we are. There we are.
Look at him.
All right, Gilbank, you ready to do this?
Yeah, I'm doing it. I'm doing the vocals over here. Yeah. Yeah. Check.
And so we're almost set.
Let's go. Oh, check, 1, 2, A, ah. Oh, A, check, 1, 2, yeah. Oh, A, check, 1, 2, ah. Oh, I got something here. It's about to feed, though. Hey, ah. Oh, hey. How's it going? How's it going? Hey, hey, ha, ho, hey, check, 1, 2. Howdy, howdy, how. Test, test. Tickle, T, ah. Oh, test. Test, tickles. What the fuck? Hey, ha, oh.
Can I have a bit more of the guitar there? Alright. Comment avec ça, pareil? Non, on va faire. Non, quoi qui va builder. Right out.
Yonder. mistake. And I've been on to see my girl in over 99 and 1 half day.
Check, 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 check. Check, check.
Might as well go back over yonder.
Live from Van Cleek Hill, it's Van Cleek Cooley, or something to that effect.
Now, more than ever, we need music! Hey, Vankley Cooley, this is Jim Wobblesock. I just wanted to call and let you know that I have a dumbbell weight set. It's missing a couple because I threw them too far. But if you want it, I'll sell it for only $84. Or maybe I'll just trade for some muscle enhancement protein shakes. Oh yeah! Later, Cooley.
Folks, this is the Vankley Cooley Show live from the Windsor Tavern. The first time we've ever done this. That is for sure. Gilbank, how are you?
I didn't even need to leave, man. I didn't even need to leave. Usually I need to leave here to get to the radio show.
Yeah, really?
Instead, I just was like, hey, I'll just turn around over here, and now I'm on the radio.
You're usually at the Windsor Tavern getting wings for us at the tavern. You know who's not here tonight?
Who's not here tonight?
No, Ernie and Lucinda.
Ernie and Lucinda are our number one fans.
Where are they?
I'm surprised. Normally we see them tracing by on Main Street.
It's kind of odd. It's kind of odd. Anyways, we're live at the Windsor Tavern tonight. The first time for Van Cleek FM. We're doing a live remote. And tonight from two doors down, the Windsor Tavern. Thanks a lot, Mike and Rob, for letting us do this here. It's, well, we normally start at 8 p.m., but we had some fun before. And
we had a couple beers, obviously, so yeah, it slowed us down.
Well, you had about three or four beers.
Yeah.
From what I noticed, anyway.
You didn't see all of them.
No, I didn't, actually. So the big deal tonight, the big deal, Gilbank, is not about talking about you at the Vankleek Hill Fair this weekend.
No, it's that it's my birthday coming up,
it
right?
It is, actually.
That's what
birthday.
It is.
Birthday. It's your birthday this weekend, isn't
this,
it?
This Friday, yeah. That's what this show's
Friday.
About. Is that what it is? Is that what it is?
Did I tell you that's what it was going to be about?
Yeah, nope. No, you didn't. So I'm just on the edge now.
Okay, so this Friday we're not doing a radio show about your birthday, but right now we're doing a radio show live at the Windsor Tavern because we got a four-piece band up on the stage right in front of us.
Yes, we do.
I don't know if you noticed them. They're right in front of us.
Yeah, I actually did. Hey, how's the guy? How you
hey, guys.
Doing? Having a good day?
Let's throw that mic on. We have the Rude Mood Band on live right in front of us here at the Windsor Tavern. Hey, guys, how are you?
Hey, we're doing well. How are you guys?
Not too bad. That's Will Lauren, the drummer of the Rude Mood Band. And so we have the Rude Mood Band from the area. Where are you guys from? Where are you guys hailing from?
Well, I'm from the only band member from Ontario that currently lives in Ontario, but the other guys can tell you where they're from.
passing the
mic
around.
We have a shy bassist over here, sorry. Okay, she's from St. Philippe Brown, as well as Jesse, originally from L'Oréal. Okay, there we go. And we have Leandre from...
You're from Lachute. You're from Lachute. Cool.
Yeah, Lachute, exactly. Yeah.
Okay, so the band hails from where?
Say Lachute.
Yeah, Lachute? Most of our practice are all at Marie-Pierre Sparrow's there in the St. Philippe, Brownsburg area. Yeah.
Where do you guys practice? In a barn or?
Rude?
Yeah.
No, we practice in her basement in her parents' place.
Sean practices lots of things in barns. That's why he usually starts with that.
I'm not being rude by saying that. I'm saying like a lot of bands practice in barns.
Yeah.
Am I not right by saying that?
Well, we have a pretty nice setup there.
Yep.
Her father's a musician too, so
it's not totally in the country, but it's borderline country. Borderline country.
Yeah, they ride their horses there, Cooley, and then they also buy all their food at the corner market on a corner stand.
You done? You done,
nope.
Gilman?
Nope, not done.
All right, so guys, thanks a lot for coming to the Windsor Tavern tonight. You guys have played here before, am I right?
Yeah, we've been once. When was it?
We played once here maybe about a month and a half ago.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
How was that show? It was a lot of fun, eh? Playing at the Windsor?
There's a lot of people, lots of drinks, lots of family, lots of food. It was a good time.
Yeah,
that's fantastic.
Absolutely. So here it is, Wednesday night, live at the Windsor Tavern. Here we are, Van Cleek Cooley, the voice of the community here in Van Cleek Hill on Van Cleek FM, 88.7 FM. And we have the Rude Mood Band on with us. And I'm going to ask right away, because we had someone here earlier watching you guys do your sound check, and he wanted to know right away, did you guys get your name from the Stevie Ray Vaughan song?
We're going to have to let Jesse Locker explain this.
Go ahead, Jesse. Go.
So I want the explanation of why you chose this name as the band name.
Well, actually, no. It's I'm honored that he thought that we took the name from that song. But
well,
actually,
it's the Stevie Ray Vaughan. He's such a hero.
Oh, actually, yeah, absolutely. To me. Personally, he's a huge influence technique-wise and sound-wise. But no, it all came up like we were setting up for a small gig in a small venue in Brownsburg. And my rig, I just got it. I was so proud. It sounded good in practice. And as soon as I got into on stage, it sounded bad. And ever since, I was in the rude mood. And they baptized me as being rude, as having a rude mood all the time, every time I played it. And, I make these faces and I seem like I'm actually in the rude mood.
You're pissed off.
Yeah, I'm pissed off all the time I set up. And
so this is straight up about the emotion.
Thing, and now it's our name. And
that's where it all started. From the Stevie Ray Vaughan, too. We're all...
Yeah, that's what they say. But no, it's me. It's all me.
Right on.
This is, it's actually Stevie Ray Vaughan who took it from me.
Yeah, that was quite some time ago there.
Time travel.
Guys, I really appreciate you coming out from all of us to you guys. Thank you very much. Coming down here to the Windsor. You guys have got a lot of stuff coming up in the next week alone. You got, what is it, four shows?
Yep.
Friday, Saturday, and twice on Sunday.
Really?
It's gonna be it's gonna be a crazy weekend, but we're
like
down.
Sounds like a good honeymoon right there.
Yeah.
Hey.
I don't get it.
I'm not there yet, Sean.
It was 14 years ago for me. So tell me about the Friday, Saturday, and twice on Sunday.
All right. So Friday we're actually playing at Top Shots in Lachute, and we did that gig last summer pretty much every weekend on the patio, the terrace, if you will.
Yeah.
And it was a good crowd. We played during
this same band.
Yeah, the same band, just like we're doing tonight, like an acoustic version of what we are.
Okay.
So not so rude, but yeah.
Get the mood.
Actually, after 11, we're rude nude.
Whoa. Playing at the Grand Barn.
The Grand Barn tonight.
The Grand Barn.
The nude, rude mood.
Man, I have a story about the Grand Barn, but
I think everyone.
That's gonna come out later.
He does, really.
All right, so that's Friday.
That's Friday. Oh, yeah. Saturday, we're playing a sold-out show at the Lornell Jail.
Yeah, that sounds awesome.
Pretty cool.
So it's totally sold out.
Yep. Totally sold.
So if I wanted to hit you up right now for a ticket for me, not a chance.
Might actually get you one.
Really? Oh, okay.
Yeah, you could also try to sneak in and then end up in jail, would...
That's exactly the purpose, though.
Into jail.
Sneak into jail. That's a first thing.
First for me, anyways.
Well, yeah, so that's Saturday. Sunday, we are playing at a festival in Saint-Sauveur called Nuit Blues, and we actually won this contest a couple weeks back, early August. We played with a bunch of other bands. We won Best Singer. Leand won Best Singer. Congratulations.
Awesome.
Round of applause for Leand.
Good for you.
Yeah, thank you very much.
We also won Best Band, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's the title.
Don't mean to toot our own horn, but...
No, toot away.
No, congratulations.
All right, so we're doing that. We're playing at 3 o'clock.
exactly.
On an outdoor stage, which is going to be pretty cool.
Next to the church there in St. Silvera.
Next to the church, St. Silvera is going to be beautiful. Lots of people there, lots of patios, lots of nightlife there. It's going to be awesome. And then we are playing at Moe's Bar and Grill for, I guess, call it an after party show or something like that. We're playing for about an hour and a half.
After festival show.
After festival, yep. So that's going to be cool.
That sounds really awesome.
Yeah.
So you guys are going to get your licks in this weekend.
Yes,
good for you guys. Now, bands I have on the show, bands we have on the show, we invite them in to just play throughout the show. And I'm going to throw to you guys now, whatever you guys want to play first, go ahead.
Okay.
You can intro it yourself. What I have right now in front of me is a four-piece band here at the Windsor Tavern, live in Van Cleek Hill on 88.7 FM, the Van Cleek Cooley radio program, Van Cleek FM. I've got the Rude Mood Blues Band live on stage here in the Windsor Tavern. And guys, whatever you want to play, we're listening.
Yeah, sure. We'll go.
What's the name of the song?
It's going to be a little B.B. King tribute.
Oh,
late,
nice.
Great B.B. King.
Yeah, absolutely.
Cyril is gone.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
know I'm free, baby. I'm free from your spell. You know I'm free, baby. I'm free from your spell. And now it's all over, baby. All I can do is wish you well. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Yeah. Quite amazing, guys. Thank you very much. Very nice. Very nice. Thank you very much. That's the Rude Mood Band live at the Windsor Tavern. Here at 84 Main Street, Van Cleek Hill. And here we go. Guys, that was amazing. What was the name of that song again?
Thrill Is Gone by the late B.B. King.
Thrill Is Gone by the late B.B. King.
Nice funky tune.
Yeah, that was amazing.
Yeah, we actually we took this song, we made like a funky version of it. It was a little faster. It's pretty cool stuff. Pretty cool. We love to play funk.
Yeah. Hey, I like to play funk as well, actually. I love playing funk. I play it off of my computer, though, most of the time. I act like I have turntables in front of me.
Don't you beatbox it sometimes?
I can beatbox funk, but it's not the same.
To hear it.
I know. Well, you're not going to hear it tonight.
I've been asking
regardless.
For like 3 years, man.
You're not going to hear it tonight, regardless of what happens here. Guys, thanks very much. That was unbelievable. So let me start with, I guess we'll start with Leon. Your main, I guess, your heroes in music. What made you want to be a singer of a band, a blues singer, and the singer of the Rude Mood Band?
Well, actually, one of my great inspiration as a blues singer were all the kings of blues, just like in the last song, B.B. King, one of the greats, Freddie King. Also on the soul side, Stevie Wonder was a great inspiration for me.
Absolutely.
To start singing. I started singing in churches when I was about 8 years older.
Really? Good for you.
I was a big soulish gospel fan, too.
Oh, yeah? That's a good place to sing, absolutely. Yeah, no one judges you.
Yeah.
And that's a good place to start.
Yeah, sure.
And Stevie Wonder, big fan of Stevie Wonder myself as well. Unbelievable singer, good pipes.
I remember you saying William Hung was another influence of yours as well.
William Hung. Now, what's the story in William Hung again? I sort of forget William Hung.
William Hung, I think he was on American Idol.
The first one.
The first one.
And they kicked him out, right?
Way back in the day.
Yeah,
they kicked him out, but I mean, I think he was still very successful. Record contract because of that performance.
Really? Yeah.
Yes.
Where he sang lots of classics
that
were very
similar.
She banged.
Exactly. That's so terrible. That's so terrible that we remember that. Speaking of
inspiration,
you know, like, why the hell are we remembering this? I listened to a report on our good friend Jared from Subway.
Oh,
you guys hear about this?
Did he get arrested?
Yeah. No.
He got arrested.
You got arrested?
Child pornography.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah.
My.
Kind of Jared.
I hear they still have footlongs in prison, though.
Yeah. I bet you I know what his nickname's going to be. He's
going to
probably do 5 years.
There.
Yeah. He's probably going to do 5 years in prison.
Oh.
No word of a lie. So I wanted to break off here just for a second, guys. As you know, you guys played the Van Cleek Hill Fair this weekend.
Yes,
right?
We did. Yeah.
I heard it was quite amazing.
It was. And I mean, if it wasn't for Paul Malone and his sound, it was just great. He does an excellent job, so we give a shout out to him.
He certainly does. He certainly does. Now, I wanted to ask Gilbank here because he's the mayor of Van Cleek Hill.
That's true. At least in 2040. That's the plan.
Yeah, maybe if we vote for you.
Well, yeah.
But I wanted to ask, how did the Van Cleek Hill Fair go, Gilbank?
It
because
seemed as
I'll just hold on. Let me let me get going here. Let
yeah.
Me just
yeah. You
just
can I go
just
now?
Hold, just now. Turn your mic off.
Okay.
But all week long, we sit in an office together all week and just sit in an office all
stare
week
at
together.
Each other.
And SWAT flies and stuff, but all week long he was smiles and chuckles. He was looking forward to the Van Cleek Hill Fair, saying it was the best weekend of the year. And you know, I just kind of laughed at him as I usually do.
That's normal.
But first thing Friday morning, what was the first night of the fair?
Thursday night.
Yeah.
Was the
first thing Friday morning, I noticed you were in a hurting basket of shape.
Yeah, there. Like there was I was carrying a bowling bag
bowling bag bags underneath my eyes.
Bowling ball bags?
That's what I was going for, but I switched it up to bags of bowling ball bags.
You were in rough shape. So Thursday night and then Friday night
again.
It
kind of just snowballs, but like the key is to just keep it going and power through it. And then enjoy fantastic bands such as these guys there. But don't actually remember too much of it, just mainly because you're supposed to enjoy it in the moment and forget most of the decisions you make that night.
Well, from what I've been told, urban legend goes, is Saturday morning they found you passed out here at the Windsor Tavern on the stage.
Yeah, I was actually on the stage. I was clutching a microphone in my hand, and they told me I was dreaming, and I was just saying, Vankly Cooley, Vankly Cooley, welcome to Vankly Cooley.
You just wanted to do Vankly Cooley.
Yeah, I was like doing it in my drunken stupor sleep.
Yeah, I believe
it. Yeah, it's maybe I was telling the future about what was going to happen tonight.
Yeah, drunken stupor, is that what you mean?
Well, that's, yeah, pretty much.
Okay. So as we get set up here, guys, I'm going to come back to you in one moment. I'm going to play a little Cooking with Cooley and Gilbank on Vankly FM. Vankly Cooley, the voice of the community, here at 84 Main Street this week, not 76, 84 Main Street, the Windsor Tavern. Again, here's Cooking with Cooley with Gilbank.
And now, Cooking with Cooley.
Hey, folks, thank you very much for tuning in again this week to Cooking with Cooley. I'm going to make a little dish in the microwave for you. I'm going to turn it on here. I'm going to warm up some milk, and then I'm going to walk over to the refrigerator. And for all you people listening to Vankly Cooley at home, this week we will not have any problems. I'm going to stir this up here. I'm just going to stir this up a little bit. Everything will work out well, folks. Everyone's going to get a free treat. I am making a smoothie here this week at Vankly Cooley. Folks, come on in the door at 76 Main Street. Everyone get... Gilbank, watch the... Gilbank!
Gilbank!
Gilbank! All right, live back here at Vankly Cooley, Vankly FM, the voice of the community here in Vankly Kill. Here we are in the Windsor Tavern, having a good time. We're having a beer. We're having a Bose Blood Tread. Have we got any Helles yet?
Yeah, there's some Helles on tap.
Why don't you get us some Helles?
Okay, I'm kind of doing a radio show right now with you, though.
I think
you want
you
me to just walk away? I'll just go get one now, okay?
All right. So let me throw over to... Jesse. Jesse, I want to ask you some questions, so grab that microphone as I lead into it. What got you into the music of blues or playing guitar? Or tell us how you got here tonight. Don't say you drove your car here.
Well, that's one reason. No.
Because it was actually
seriously,
a band.
It's my, I got to give it all to my father. He's my biggest influence since I was a kid. He used to play venues, festivals, and rehearsal at my house, and I used to sit in front of him and watch him for hours and hours and want to be a part of that. So he's the man in Jesse Lochran history. He's the one.
That's what you were looking up to all through your life.
Yeah. Well, I mean, there was other influence, like David Gilmour from Pink Floyd. He's my...
Yeah, you know, I've heard of him, yeah.
Yes. There's also the great Jimi Hendrix, which I'm an absolute fan of the guy, of his technique, of his style, the way he dresses up. His sound, what he made out of a guitar, it was just abnormal.
He did things that were never done before.
He was things that actually, he did things that were actually illegal to a guitar.
Really?
Yeah, well, wow. The same. It's illegal to sound like him.
At least in most states.
Yeah.
I see. So that's what got you into playing music. You were following your father's mentorship. And
absolutely,
that's what brought you here today.
Not too long ago, one of my main uncle, my uncle got married, and we actually played his wedding. We had a band called the Wedding Singers, and we were me, my father, and also my brother playing live. And it's
that
pretty
sounds cool.
Cool.
Yeah. That sounds really cool.
Yeah, it was fun.
A family band.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, that's the family was dominating.
Like the
band.
Family Brown.
There you go. Like
Remember
Van Halen.
Brown?
We were better than Van Halen back then.
Like Van Halen, the two guys.
There you go.
And Van Halen. Cool. That's very cool. So I know the bassist doesn't want to talk, so we won't go there right now. Are you guys ready to play another tune and or bring me down an alley and
absolutely,
you know, beat me senseless with blues music?
Yeah. Well, we'll go pretty much on the funky side there.
We'll go on one of his influences, Stevie Wonder.
Yeah.
Stevie Wonder. Cool.
A la Rude Mood.
Here we go. Rude Mood live at the Windsor Tavern here, 84 Main Street, Van Cleek Hill.
I'm kind of getting paid, right?
No, yeah, you're getting paid.
Okay, good.
So again, live from the Main Street Studios, here tonight in the Windsor Tavern, we have the Rude Mood Band live. on Van Cleef Cooley. Thanks a lot for doing that, guys. That was Superstitious by Stevie Wonder. That was a well-done rendition of that
Very
song.
Very good.
I love that song. Stevie Wonder, any funk music, really, anywhere from that plummeting down into the funk music. James Brown, the P-Funk, anywhere in there. I love that stuff. What's that?
Oh, yeah.
I should throw your mic on. What's that?
I said even Mars, too, man. He's
yeah,
great.
Absolutely. He's totally funky. Yeah. Anything funky, I love that. That's good tunes.
Is that on?
We have an air conditioner.
The air conditioner is ruining everything, as they always do.
Gilbank, it's usually you that ruins everything.
Oh, that's what they say? I keep on thinking they're saying air conditioner.
That's what I tell you.
Oh, that's why I don't listen to you very well.
Yeah, thanks a lot for that. So here we are at the Windsor Tavern, guys. Thank you very much.
See, air conditioners. Always the air conditioners.
That was the air conditioner?
Yes, I told you.
That was your microphone that was feeding.
It had nothing to do with me spilling this beer onto this soundboard.
So, guys, tell me, what do you guys want to do with yourselves as a band in the next year? Do you just want to keep prepping your craft? Do you just want to keep playing shows? Or do you want to record? What's going to happen with the Rude Mood Band?
Well, I mentioned recording because in that contest that I mentioned before we played, one of the prizes was we get 16 hours of free recording time. So
wow, that's a long time.
Yeah, so basically 2 days in the studio, which is pretty cool. We're going to get a demo out, and there's a conversation going on. There's two conversations going on here.
Yeah, I'm watching the conversations going on.
No, we got... Jesse, come on.
Back to you.
Back to me. All right, here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
Will's on the mic.
16 hours of studio time, which is pretty cool. This is
it's
going to
sound a lot like what just happened right there. Yeah. Like, most, like, 10 hours of that is just going to be you guys
talking.
Are you going?
Back and forth.
Are you going now?
No, you did. You know what?
Jesse,
no,
come on.
What song do you want to play?
What song are we playing?
No. That's what the conversation's going to be like in the studio, the 16 hours. No, but trust me, I know what studio time is like. I've paid for a lot of it and wasted most of it.
Yeah.
And that's why he's not a famous rap artist.
Yeah.
Or a famous breakdancer.
Well, yeah, actually,
I wanted to broach the subject now. Part of wanting you guys on the show is that you guys are fantastic, up and coming, and playing a lot of shows right now. But I also wanted
you're missing one thing, though.
You guys really are. Who and how do I sign up to be your breakdancer live on stage for you? I don't know if there's room for me on the stage at the prison this week, but in the coming weeks I'll get my routine ready. And I can come up on stage with you guys and breakdance.
Well, you know what?
He's actually open to all types of dancing, interpretive,
deal,
whatever you need.
I'll make you a deal. Okay. But let's say we get a gig at a mental institution and you want to come and breakdance.
Yeah, I'll be there.
You'll be there.
You realize you do have a gig at a jail. A mental institution is not that unlikely.
So we're one step away here. Yeah. If you want to do that, you'll fit in with the I'm sure.
So, Gilbank, it worked.
Congratulations.
They said yes.
I thought it was going to be a lot more convincing than this and probably several more beers, but
they said yes, though.
A mental institution, that's all we got to find, one with a paying gig.
They said yes is all I heard there. So, guys, I'm going to throw back to you. What other tunes do you want to play for us here live at the Windsor Tavern? What's coming up next? What do you feel like playing?
We're going to play a little song called Red House.
Red House.
Classic blues song.
Classic blues song by the Rude Mood Band live at the Windsor Tavern.
Tavern. I'm just going to have another beer, man.
That's two beers. Tavern. All right, guys, take it away.
Thank you.
so yonder. That's where my favorite stays.
The Rude Mood Band live at 84 Main Street, Van Cleek Hill, the Windsor Tavern. That was an amazing song, guys. You're just putting me into a place right now. This is quite amazing. Thank you very much for doing that. What I'm going to do right now is I'm going to play two songs back-to-back, some Willie Mitchell and some Willis Allen Ramsey, to give us a little break. We can all stretch our legs and chat to each other off the microphone. All right, guys, here we go. This is the Van Cleek Cooley radio program. Live at the Windsor Tavern tonight.
across the country, playing on the circuit line. Sometimes I think about a man who's here before my time. Name for the 28th president with a Guthrie tag to the end. Born in Okima shoes with the Dust Bowl blues, a friend of the working man. Now he was impartial to New York buildings and tried to touch the sky. The West Virginia coal mines, it took so many lives. Oh, the way they drove the migrant workers back over into Mexico way, and the scalps they run when the herd he'd come, and the bosses started to pray. Just a boy from Oklahoma on an endless one-night stand, wandering and rambling, drifting with the midnight sand. They played the blues and the ballads and all that came between. His heart was in the Union and his soul dream. I can see you bright eyes
I can see your smile. I can tell by your supper song that you could drive a sane man wild. With your slow hair flowing free there, and those big green eyes staring back at me. But it's just fine when you put your hand in mine and we lay in the shade of the big magnolia tree. And I'm a wild, wild, wild melon man. Why don't you come to the cabin, bring your wild melon patch? We'll dance in the meadows. What more could I? What more could I? Let's go find a cover. Back for summer's dream. I can't think of many others that can eat their watermelon the way that they play. And it's a new day, watermelon's raised away, and the sun is starting to rise up over the hill. But it's okay, I haven't lost my appetite, and you know that I'm eating those wasted watermelons still. Yes, I am, and I'm a wild, wild melon man. Yes, I'm a wild, wild melon man. Lordy, I'm a mom, baby. Honey, I'm a wild melon man. Yeah. Get it now.
Yeah.
Hey, Gilbank.
I'm just playing the trumpet over here.
That's me on the electric accordion.
Electric accordion.
Do you see me there? I'm playing the guitar.
Oh, there you are. Yeah, okay.
Look at me. I'm Van Cleek Cooley. Van Cleek FM, the voice of the community.
The voice.
Here in Van Cleek Hill, 88.7 FM. Jean Sarazan Radio on the Wheels of Steel. Hey, folks, that's me, Van Cleek Cooley, on the guitar.
I'm just playing the trumpet over here. Yeah, I'm playing the trumpet, too. This is me playing the trumpet. I'm not even using my mouth.
You're fantastic.
I know. It's hard to bend over.
This is The Eye of the Hurricane by Herbie Hancock.
I'm just playing the trumpet over here.
Herbie Hancock, one of the
most hilarious names.
Yeah. I wasn't going to think about it that way. But one of the most sampled gentlemen on earth. But what I wanted to say is...
I'm just playing the trumpet over here.
Hey there, Rankly Cooley. I'm just calling because I got a real problem with something here. I'm just so god-dang annoyed with all these young kids these days and their frickin' selfie sticks. What is a selfie stick? This is... Back in my day, we paid a man 18 shillings, and he drew a picture for you on a piece of birch bark. God, these damn kids, I freaking hate them. Ah.
Okay, there comes a time.
And welcome back to Van Cleek Cooley, folks. Here we are live in the Windsor Tavern. This is a lot of fun. We're talking over some J. Dilla right now.
And some beers.
And some beers. Talking over beers, talking over a microphone and my laptop and a piece of paper, actually.
Yeah, and my microphone stand is better, too. I had a paper towel roll before.
Yeah.
I thought I was pretty good and clever, but apparently I was not.
Yeah.
I sound great right now.
Yeah, Jean Sarazan took care of you, as he takes care of everyone here. You know what? Your microphone coming out of a microphone stand sounds a lot better. Oddly enough, it sounds better than coming out of a
paper towel roll.
Did you not figure that out? Or?
Well, I just didn't know. You know what? You need to give me a raise if I'm going to educate myself in any of this stuff.
Well, obviously you're not.
Well, that's why. Anyways, we have it.
Gilbank.
Yeah?
Are you done?
You haven't told me to shut up in a long time.
No, Gilbank, shut up.
Oh.
Shut up.
Okay,
We're going to turn the J. Dilla down right now and throw it back to the Rude Mood Band. We've had a bit of an intermission here at the Windsor Tavern. We're having a lot of fun here tonight in the Windsor Tavern.
Yeah, they actually did 4 rounds of shots while they were in their intermission.
I couldn't believe.
I was really impressed, guys.
And that was just Will.
That was just...
Like 4 rounds himself. It was kind of weird. It was kind of weird.
I don't know
Typical
where you
drummer.
Him. Don't know where you put him.
I know, right?
Yeah, where did you put them? Will, I noticed right beside your drum kit, yep. Do you have a fan?
I do.
You
want
That's
to turn
wow,
on?
Pampering.
I think it's because everyone's just distracted by your flowing hair.
it's my number one fan.
Oh, yeah.
Stuff fan 2.0, because the other one blew up.
Do you bring that fan with you?
Pardon me?
Do you bring that fan with you?
That's not like a normal Windsor stage fan.
It has to come everywhere. So.
Wow, it's engraved with his name, and it's in gold. I'm impressed.
Yeah, well, it's actually called. It says Honeywell, but we call it Stefan.
So on the front of your kick drum, your kick snare, there it says I am William. Is that just a reminder? Well, or?
It also says Happy Face.
What's that?
Let me tell you a little story about that.
Uh-oh.
That microphone cut out there.
Back when we played the same song for a couple weeks ago.
We're good.
It's a French competition, and I'm the least French person in this band.
No, okay.
Right?
No.
I couldn't tell.
They were doing an interview, a live interview, and I was asking the guys, how do you say, I'm William, I play the drums. And I guess because they're used to speaking in French, you know, some of their words are slurred, so other French people understand it. They told me to say what I thought I heard was, moi, j'ai William, j'ai joué le tron. So that's what I said.
And say that last part again. Say that last part again.
J'ai joué le tron.
Okay, j'ai joué le tron.
Right. And so apparently that means I have William, I play the drums. So I decided to put that on my drum kit with the help of our lovely bass player who still doesn't talk.
Very nice, very nice. The speechless bass player, Mary.
Saving her voice for the last song where she has a huge solo.
Oh, yeah. Celine Dion cover coming up.
Oh, wow. Celine Dion cover.
Wow.
Live at the Windsor. Wow, it's unbelievable.
It wouldn't be the first, won't be the last.
No, not at all.
Especially with the Windsor Idol.
So, yeah, that's true. Eh? When is that? When's that coming up?
It's I don't know. It's sometime this year.
Don't you plan this stuff? Aren't you the promoter?
No, I just attend all and usually partake.
you partake, you attend everything, you sleep here.
Oh, yeah, I like I sleep here. Yeah, that's true.
You tend bar, and you also kegged a...
I tap the kegs in the back. I built a small brew pub in the back, and I actually brew some of the beer that we drink, which is really... Yeah, are you not impressed? Are you not entertained?
No, it's fantastic, actually. I wanted to throw it back to the band here right now. And Leandre, I am a huge fan of the Rolling Stones. And the Rolling Stones are a blues band at the very basic end of the band. They have a song called Little Red Rooster. Do you guys know that song by chance? I am the Little Red Rooster. What's that? Say again.
That's actually Howling Wolf song there, eh?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, but we don't know it actually. Okay.
Sorry for putting you on the spot there. That was kind of rude of me actually.
Yeah, worst radio host.
Yeah, worst ever. Radio host ever. I'm really sorry about that.
We'll put it on the list though.
Some old blues is what I'd like to request. I should have said this to you before I threw it at you, but I'm saying it to you now.
Can you play this song that you might not play that I just want you to play right now?
I just want you to play the song I want to hear.
Rolling Stone did a show once with the Muddy Waters.
Oh, yeah.
They had the Oochie Coochie Man going on.
Yeah.
We could do a song.
You guys got a song for us?
Sure.
Oochie Coochie Man.
Hoochie Coochie Man by Rod Gilbank. All right, guys. Rude Mood, live at the Windsor Tavern, 84 Main Street, Van Cleek Hill on the Van Cleek Coolie Radio program in Van Cleek Hill, 88.7 FM, the voice of the community. Here we go. I'm done talking. Okay.
Told me when I was a little child, say, son, one day you'll be the baddest man alive. Now I'm a man, I'm a rather big man. I'm a man, I'm a rolling stone. I'm a man, spells M-E-child-N. That goes out for men. And O-V, oh, child, Y. Boy, gypsy woman told my mother before I was born, say, you got a boy child coming, he gonna be a son of a gun, ain't gonna make all these girls running and jumping and
shout, yeah, and the whole might the world know. What's this all about that you know me? Everybody knows I'm you. Well, I'm your hoochie-coochie man. Everybody knows I'm you. Got a blackout bone and a mojo too. I got a junk just messing with you. I'm gonna make all these girls leave me by my hand, and then the whole my coochie belt, you know I'm him. Everybody knows I'm him. Well, I'm your seventh hour, on the seventh day, I want to last month, seventh doctor said, you will bump look, and that you'll see, I got 700, baby. Everybody knows I'm here. Yeah. Woo.
Very nice, guys. Very nice. Thank you very much again. Thank you very much. That was unbelievable. Hoochie Coochie Man. That was unreal. Do you guys practice once, twice, three times a week?
We try what?
You try
well,
what?
I'd say, I don't know, Monday night's for everybody, so, but if we have, you know, a pretty big show coming up, you try to fit in two practices a week, my bad.
Try to fit in two shows, if we have the time.
Yeah, if we feel like
spend it. Spend a lot of time with our tour bus waxing it.
So, you guys are doing four shows in 3 days coming up. How many practices do you have to do to lead up to that one?
Oh my gosh, what?
Practices?
One? Wednesday.
Yeah, I guess you got one more night.
This is our practice.
This is kind of like a practice for you tonight.
It's
just getting you ready.
Last practice before.
This is it. Well, you know what, guys?
What's up?
You're welcome.
You're very welcome, guys.
Yeah, this is all for you. This is fantastic. No, we really appreciate you guys coming and doing this here tonight. Wanted to ask you guys. So you're all of you've been in bands before this, correct? You've been in.
Yeah,
bands.
I have.
Never.
Yeah, we have.
Or just performed alone, whatever, just in different cases and whatnot.
Gilbank, we're not talking about performing alone,
we've
are we?
We've all performed in other bands before, except for our bass player here.
Really?
Would you like to talk about it more? Yeah. Okay, moving on.
So, Will, you performed, you and Ian performed on, I think, the third Van Cleef Cooley radio program live, two houses down.
Yeah.
Here in Van Cleef Hill.
Houses.
About a year and a half ago. Shut up, Gilbank. And you guys kind of, I think you were the first band.
Are you serious?
Yeah, they were. You guys were the first musical talent in there.
And cool. I really appreciate that as well. So I guess, Will, you've got the microphone right now. How many other iterations of bands have you been in your life?
My life, oh my gosh. Okay, so...
When did you start drumming?
When did I start drumming? Let's go back to when I was 9 years old.
Okay.
The first song I learned how to play on drums was Smash Mouth's All Star.
Okay.
You know that song?
Yes.
Gilbank loves it. It's pretty,
they're my...
High school? I heard they had to like create a different part of the building for him.
There was also a shorter...
Spinning the wheel, like America.
Okay, hold on. You toured France twice.
I was in before. Other than that, I'm in a radio rock band. It was called White Mariah. Shout out.
What did you call the band? The Ilk?
And I'm like, yeah, sure, why not? Let's do it.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then...
From The Boys.
To play,
so you guys didn't have a drummer before this?
Well, Brian asked us...
Andre. Tell me where your history is in the music.
It's a mellow man like
football.
Well, I'm not, as you could see, a big guitar player. I'm mostly a singer. Here's my guitar. I could sing. I could play guitar. Years ago, go into jams again with Brian. We hooked up a couple of months later on to last.
Outside.
Wow.
Now you're speaking.
I really could feel that from you. I could tell that was in there.
Well, when I started playing guitar, I started in a country band. Dreams is to form an 80s band and do all the greatest hits, you know.
What's funny is I could say I agree with that myself. Like, I love that stuff. But Cooley, I could see him.
No,
I could see
there were hair bands in the 80s. The 80s were the reason I became a rapper. And the 80s were blasted from the room next to me in my house growing up. And I was blasting rap music. She was blasting my sister, that is. She's 6 years older than me. She was blasting 80s music. I was blasting rap music. Anyways, it's not about me. It's about you guys.
Let me ask you this, though.
Yeah, okay.
Who were you listening to back in the day that was rap in those days?
In those days?
Yeah.
We're talking to that, right?
Yeah. Like,
anyways. To each their own, and I've got Eyes Wide Open. So, guys, I'm going to throw it back to you again. Let's play some more music. See? maybe not. Here we go.
I want you to love me. I want you to love me. I want you to love me. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. You know what pleases. Well, I want you to kiss me. Time and night, and lips making me feel alright. Keep on loving me, girl. I'm loving my baby. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
power pleases.
Guys, all of you at the same time saying, shut up, Gilbert. One, two, three.
Shut up, Gilbert!
Okay.
All right, so lots of shows coming up. Next weekend, you have another show. What's going on there?
On the 28th in the shoot. I'm not sure the name of that one.
That's Chanté en Blue.
There you go.
So that's it. It's 9:15 at the Pack Bottle.
How do people get in touch with the Rude Mood Band if they want to book you on stage?
Well, the best way is by Facebook. We have our page on Facebook. So you just type in Rude Mood.
Yeah.
And you'll find us. You'll see our
we'll be the first ones to pop up.
Yeah.
It's just a full page ad comes up, and it's just a huge, huge zoomed in versions of your face.
Right. Or Jesse's.
Fantastic. It's the same thing for Cooley's website.
Yeah, exactly. My website. Don't have one. So, guys, we're going to be chiming out here in a couple moments. If you guys want to chat, if you want to put together a final song, that's quite fine. Until then, Gilbank and I are going to chat wax poetics about last week at the Van Cleek Hill Fair. Gilbank made a fool out of himself, as usual. He went
to.
And, well, committed adultery with
I did several things
cows,
that I'm not supposed to do.
One of the cows.
Yeah.
And,
it's a tradition.
You know, you were banned again from the Van Cleek Hill Fair.
Yep.
Even though they'll let you back
the
in.
The band hit me in the back of, back of my head with a guitar.
You guys want to play again, though?
Or
that, sorry, no. I was saying if you guys want to play again.
Yeah, if you want to play again,
we'll chat a bit.
We'll chat, and
then
you
guys
decide.
Want to play again. Sorry, I know I'm.
Cooley's really hard to understand. He actually only speaks hip hop, and no one understands what he's talking
about.
Sorry,
guys, I'm really stupid that way. If you guys want to play one more song, if you don't, that's quite fine. I know Gilbank is very ignorant. If you guys want to play one more song, but again, Gilbank got kicked out of the Van Cleek Hill Fair last week again.
Yep. I almost didn't get let in because I almost forgot to bring, like on Sunday when they only let the locals in, I almost forgot to bring my birth certificate to say it was actually a local.
But you being the
but they
mayor
knew who I
the,
was. I let them take a picture with me, and they were nice enough to let me in. I didn't charge them either.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah, so that was nice of them, where I proceeded to drink several beers and, you know, just, I think I got up on stage at one point too. I did that. Mostly it was just girls, but then at the end I was... like, this is sexist, and I should get up there.
Didn't you tell me, though, this is for real now. Gilbank told me his leg was hurting him this week.
Oh, yeah.
And he also said he was doing a lot of dancing up at this on stage at the Van Cleek Hill Fair.
I do more dancing in those 3 days, but more specifically Sunday, than I do, I think, my entire year round,
and
including all weddings and all stupors at the Windsor.
And you wear a cowboy hat.
I wear a full hat cowboy hat and definitely the cowboy boots. Yeah. It's really easy to find me in a crowd. It's a good time. You should have come.
Well, I was going to go, but my daughter was sick. And my son went to the Van Cleek Hill Fair. He said there was barely any rides.
Well, yeah, probably. You're not supposed to bring your kids, Cooley.
All right, so from all of us at the Van Cleek Cooley and 88.7 FM. I want to thank you guys for coming. Rude Mood.
Thank you guys.
Sorry, we got started a little late, but we had a lot of fun.
We did.
And for Leandra, Jesse, Marie, and William, really appreciate it. If you guys want to stop by anytime, I would really love that. Stick around after. We'll help you pack up and we'll have a beer or two.
And I'm sure you guys will be playing this venue, the Windsor Tavern, in the future.
Yeah,
that'll be a good time.
We're open
you've been there once. You'll be back in our local paper. Yeah. As I look over at Luis.
All right, guys, off to you. The show of Ankley Cooley. This is Rude Mood with what's the song's name?
It's going to be a Withers. Bill Withers, Ain't No Sunshine.
Ain't No Sunshine. All right, folks, thanks a lot for listening to this radio program. From all of us, again, to the Rude Mood Band. Appreciate it, and thanks very much. Here we go.
Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. It's not warm when she's away. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. And this house ain't no home anytime she goes away. Dirty somewhere she's gone. And I wonder if she's gonna stay. No sunshine when she's gone. Time she goes away. And I know, 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 I know. Hey, you wanna leave a young thing alone? Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. No sunshine, she's gone. Sunshine. It sounds just ain't no home. Anytime she goes away.